Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall. About to approach the ring area from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 284 pounds, a Junkyard Dog.
Junkyard Dog doing his thing with that 15-foot chain here in Beantown. Grab them cakes indeed.
Is that left over from when his parents kept him in the backyard?
I don't know. I think it's part that was left over from the junkyard.
His opponent will be escorted to the ring area by his bodyguard, Virgil, making his autumn residence in Bel Air, California, weighing 206.
Look at the million-dollar man on crutches. What is this?
62 pounds.
I know.
You know?
Yes.
Enlighten us.
The million-dollar man.
You will be in a moment.
All right.
I don't want to, you know, kill the suspense for you.
Okay. And Virgil pointing over to Howard Finkel, asking for the microphone. Million-dollar man obviously injured here, perhaps.
It's a shame the way the crowd treats that man who is obviously one of the greatest philanthropists in the United States.
Well, it should be obvious to all you people by now that you're not going to have the extreme honor and privilege of seeing me wrestle here today. Obviously, I'm hurt. Let me tell you something, Junkyard Dog. It doesn't disappoint anybody any more than it does me. Because I was really looking forward to kicking your butt here today. But don't think that you're going to get off without breaking a sweat. Just because I'm not going to embarrass and humiliate you doesn't mean that it's not going to happen. Because Virgil here is going to take up my slack.
All the pain rolled to me, myself.
Virgil from behind, lowering the boom on the Junkyard Dog. It is official. Virgil filling in for the injured Ted DiBiase. The dog had a little problem with the microphone, and it may cost him something here.
Well, of course, you know, I don't think the trouble was with the microphone. It was the trouble with the mouth, knowing what to say and how to use it.
Well, I don't believe he thought he was getting out.
Virgil is one of the best man Fridays that anyone could ever have.
Look at this now. Virgil distracting the referee, and DiBiase really doing a number on the dog. Doesn't appear to me he's hurt all that bad.
Ted's whipping the dog.
He is limping.
Virgil's doing quite a number on it. Junkyard Dog.
Virgil, obviously in tremendous physical condition. And once again, DiBiase unloading here.
Ted's helping him out, obviously, because he's weightless.
Can't believe he didn't hit him with a crutch out there. Uh-oh, dog's on his feet. Irish whip, and look out, here comes. Went downstairs. Look at the look on the dog's face. He looks like, well, he went down with that shot, but
looks like an English bulldog.
Look at Virgil.
He sort of got impervious to pain there.
He's gonna whip that dog.
Virgil, very high risk move, perched up there on the top turnbuckle, bombs away. Oh, nice block by the dog.
Lucky move by the dog, lucky move by the dog.
Virgil with a haphazard, half-hearted right hand. And another one blocked by the dog.
Doesn't look like Friday's got as much high a degree of intestinal fortitude as the dog does.
DiBiase really bent out of shape on the outside as those canes are literally flying around those crutches, I'm sorry.
DiBiase wants to get a hold of that dog. Look at
him. Oh, headbutt right in the face.
Does the thump on the back of the dog's trunks, is that his word for today?
Well, the thump, he refers to the thump as the power slam. That's the thump as far as he's concerned. And that is his forte. And right now, Virgil in deep trouble.
On the side of his legs.
Oh!
Who he is.
Oh, referee went down. There's the power slam. Look at this. $1 million man with the crutch. Oh, come on. DiBiase, bad leg at all, pulling Virgil over on top. I can't believe this.
Come on, ref, get up and count. Get up and count, ref.
Referee was kicked right in the head by Virgil as the dog picked him up in a slam. Oh, no.
Absolutely, Virgil did it. Virgil, fantastic.
What a miscarriage of justice here in Beantown.
I guess I'd have to agree with you, but somehow or another, there's a certain poetic justice about it.
There is.
The ruling factor.
I failed to see that.
The ruling factor is the referee.
Virgil! What poet you like.
Ted DiBiase, Virgil, and the referee beat the Junkyard Dog. That's three against one. Here it comes.
This is a
very innocent move on this part. You can see the referee trying to stay close to the action. Got a kick right in the head by the leg of Virgil as the dog picked him up. He was out cold, of course. Ted DiBiase, as crippled as he is, still got in the ring. Delivered a nice little blow with that crutch.
Didn't look all that crippled to me, Nick Bockwinkel.
Well, I saw his knee. It was operated on.
Ted DiBiase, absolutely phenomenal.
Virgil out of it, the dog out of it. A miscarriage of justice here in Beantown. Plenty more action, though, still coming up. We'll be back.